Say you want to go from India to Mexico, and you will think the shortest distance will be a straight line, but it is not. Believe me, the shortest distance will be all the way around Greenland, Canada, USA, and to Mexico. So this big long curved line is the shortest distance, not this straight line distance. Why? Let's learn. Let's calculate distance from Mumbai to Mexico. It plots a long curved line of 15,640 kilometers. Let's ask Google Map to measure distance, and we'll have a stopover at Dakar before continuing to Mexico. Okay, it's not a straight line and not a curved line. But watch the distance. It is over 18,000 kilometers, longer than the curved line. Let's move the Dakar point up north. Keep an eye on the distance. See, the more you go north, the distance decreases. And when we revert back to 3D globe, we can see that the shortest distance from Mumbai to Mexico is really via Greenland. Now let's fly from Perth, Australia to Rio in Brazil. In a 2D map, it looks straight to Brazil. But why is it taking me via Antarctica? And when we change our map to 3D globe, we see indeed the shortest distance from Perth to Rio is over Antarctica. Let's find out what it is. Let me draw our route on this 2D map. This route is called geodesic. By definition, a geodesic is the shortest path between two points on a sphere or Earth's surface in this case. Yes, it is carved with the curvature of the Earth's surface. Okay, but what is this straight line? It is called a Rhumb line. A Rhumb line is a path with constant bearing with reference to the true north. So you can also call a Rhumb line as a constant and continuous azimuth between two points. This is especially very useful to the mariners. Suppose you are going from Sydney, Australia to San Francisco in US by a ship. You plot a straight course and it cuts all the meridians exactly at same angle. And this charted yellow dotted line is a Rhumb line. Note that this line between Sydney and San Francisco is not the shortest route. But a mariner will follow this route as it makes life easier for him, as he does not have to constantly adjust his course to follow the geodesic line. One more fact about Rhumb line. If you start from equator with any azimuth or bearing, say 080, and continue on the same bearing, you will eventually reach the North Pole. So next time you are planning to visit the poles on an aeroplane, take any direction greater or lesser than 90 degree or 270 degree. You will be there eventually. Take care. I'll see you soon.